He's 5 foot two and he's 6 feet four. He fights with missiles and with spears. And he's all of 31 and he's only 17. And he's been a soldier for 1,000 years. He's a Catholic, a Hindu, an atheist, a chain, a Buddhist and a Baptist and a Jew. And he knows he shouldn't kill, but he knows he always will kill you. For me, my friend, and me for you. He's fighting for Canada, he's fighting for France, he's fighting for the USA. And he's fighting for the Russians, and he's fighting for Japan, and he thinks he'll put an end to war this way. He's fighting for democracy, he's fighting for the Reds, he says it's for the peace of war. He's the one who must decide who's to live and who's to die, and he never sees the writing on the wall. But without him, how could Hitler have condemned him at Dachau? Without him, Caesar would have stood alone. He's the one who gives his body as a weapon of the war, and without him, all this killing can't go on. Yes, he's the universal soldier, and he really is to blame. His orders come from far away no more. They come from him and you and me, and brothers, can't you see? This is not the way we put an end to war.